Welcome back, I'm Andrew, and today I'm going to be comparing the DJI FPV drone against the upgraded DJI Avata. I brought them out today, it's going to be the last time I'm flying the DJI FPV drone. We're here at a local Sonoma park where it's nice and open, and I'm going to fly the two drones and talk about the differences. Yeah, I'll just start with some cool features that I like. They included the gyro data for the camera. So when you film in the proper settings, you can stabilize the footage in post. It's really useful with gyro flow because you can choose how stable you want it to be. You can also correct the lens distortion for the footage, which can be useful because of the wide angle distortion. They also have 10-bit color for this camera, although there is a catch. You have to update the Avata in order to have those. If you buy it now, you'll likely have to use remote ID with the Avata. So every time you fly your drone, you have to have your phone connected to the goggles in order to be able to take off. That's a huge difference for the FPV drone compared to the Avata. With the FPV drone, you don't have to worry about remote ID, and with Avata, that's something you have to think about now. This is the gear bag. I've been able to carry everything with it. Here, I have the DJI FPV goggles too, which I'm going to be doing a giveaway.
So make sure you stay till the end to find out how to win.
Lean towards the Avata, the camera is nicer. It has the gyro data for you. The camera is a larger sensor, so it's slightly wider. It lets in more light. The DJI FPV's camera was a little grainy and people weren't that big of a fan of it. The Avata's tuning, it flies around like a cine whoop, flies smoothly to get you those nice cinematic shots. Whereas the FPV drone is tuned more like a racing drone and it just takes off. And when it turns, it's not too worried about being smooth. Speed and power. Avata does not have the speed or the power, and the FPV drone.
This baby was a beast. With the Avata, I could easily fly low and close to the ground and just cruise along. But then with this, once I hit the throttle, it just like zooming all over the place. And I'm just like, oh shit. Don't crash into anything.
It can easily go up to 80 miles per hour, and Avata, after I upgraded it, it barely goes over 55 miles per hour. Modifiable. The Avata is modifiable. The stock Avata is underpowered and slow. On the plus side, the Avata is upgradable if you're willing to pay for new motors and solder them on. It raises the power considerably. If you do go with an Avata, I would recommend upgrading it. And I soldered with no experience, and you can too. You can check out my video for any tips to how to get that done. Stabilization. The Avata has gyro data, so you can change the stabilization in post. FPV drone does not. So you have to go with the built-in stabilization, and Rocksteady hasn't been that steady. I found myself needing to use stabilizer in post.
Comparing this, DJI goggles too.
If you go with the Avata, you can pair it with the newer goggles.
It's a touchpad here now, so you can control all your settings with this.
You can get better penetration with Avata since you can pair them with the newer goggles. But FPV drone right now is only compatible with the DJI FPV goggles too. There's some UI in the goggles where it looks like there will be some backwards compatibility with other drones, so we have to wait for DJI to release it. I'm giving away the DJI FPV goggles too. I had so much fun during the first giveaway. I was trying to think, what else can I give away? And it hit me. Oh, I could give away these. So I ordered goggles too. That way I could give away the FPV goggles too. I even got it new antennas so it would have better penetration. To enter the giveaway, like, subscribe, and comment which drone you want to get and where you want to fly it. Okay, propellers. As you can see, for the Avata, they're already on the drone. You don't have to worry about it. You can pack it away as is. With the FPV drone, you actually have to take the propellers off because if you don't, you'll have a hard time fitting this into places.
See, look, it takes up so much room, having to try and stuff it with all these batteries.
That was something I found inconvenient. But if you want the power and the speed for the price, it's a smaller price to pay. For frequency, the Avata is higher pitch.
It's a lower frequency, so it's just doesn't sound as loud. Before we got the Avata, Stephanie used to think this was loud. But now, it's not so bad anymore. It's always relative, huh?
So when it comes down to it, the FPV drone just takes more space. With the Avata, DJI really tried to make things more compact with the Avata. The footprint is much smaller. So I would definitely go with the Avata if you have the money to spend and you want a smaller footprint to carry around. You'd have to think about, should I upgrade the Avata or not? The DJI FPV drone is still a good option. It's a really good place to get started with the FPV drone. So if you feel like you're stuck in a rut, stuck in a loop, and you want to break out of it and go on an adventure or just